Hey guys, it's Lou and welcome back to my YouTube channel. I have finally reached the awkward fringe stage, so I don't know what to do with my hair today. So first off, Simon's gonna come and pick me up, as always. We are heading down to Sheffield today, and then after, we're gonna go and get some food, and then a little later on, I am so excited for this. I've been waiting to go here for such a long time now. Last year, I was actually supposed to get Simon tickets, but there was like this whole COVID thing happening, so I was like unsure on going just in case it got cancelled. But we are off to see Sheffield Steelers today and I can't wait. But yes, this has been a long time coming. I don't know what to do with my hair just yet in terms of the fringe section. I tried to put like a fringe in it and I was just like, it just doesn't look the same. It doesn't look right. So I don't know what to do yet. Not sure, but I've like curled the ends kind of. Just made it kind of cute. I also have two pairs of shoes on right now and I do not know which ones to wear. I either have my Converse or my feelers. I am kind of feeling the feelers a little bit more, but I really want to wear the Converse because they kind of go with the jumper. Feelers or Converse? This is the outfit today. Her Zara jeans, this jumper from a charity shop, I believe. And then underneath, I've got like a crop top on. Oh, the feelers do look better. Oh, it's gonna have to be feelers. Speaking of shoes, I actually really want to get a new pair just because I have the Nike Air Force and they are broken. I actually wear them to work now anyway, but they used to be like the go-to shoes. Everyone used to wear the Nike Air Force. I do have Converse, I have these, but they always make my feet so cold. Like, does anyone else have this problem with Converse? Because it's so strange. And then obviously I've got my feelers, which are also kind of breaking on the inside. I never undo shoelaces, I just put them on like this. So every single pair of shoes that I own, the backs are just broken off. Even my wellies at work, I wear wellies, and I've noticed that the insides are just like ripping. So yeah, I just can't put shoes on apparently. I have my snow fairy, so I'm gonna put that on. So I'm going to be vlogging on my G7X today. Very, very exciting thing. I've learned how to get my other camera, my M50, I've learned how to get it to manually focus. It's been like a year now and every time I pull that camera out, I've got to like focus it every time. And a lot of clips that you'll see on my channel, if I am using that camera, they'll always be out of focus every now and again. And I've just learned how to, you know, get it to focus itself, which is ridiculous. I've had it for so long now, but I am so excited. I feel like I've got a brand new camera again. Like I can't wait to use it. I was gonna bring it today, but then I was like, I don't want to be too obnoxious. But yeah, I can't wait. I've been told it's very like Americanized, like with the music and the screens and bringing people up on dance cams and stuff. So I'm actually very nervous. Hopefully I don't get picked for anything like that. Stuff like that gives me anxiety. And apparently the mascot goes around as well. And if you haven't got like a jersey on or anything, he picks someone from the crowd and gives you a free jersey. So like, who knows, it might be me. Jokes. It's never me. But yes, let's see what my fringe looks like. Look, what is this? I don't know what to do. No, unless I do like a cute little twist. I might just have to do that. And then anyone that's had a fringe before knows that there's the awkward growing out stage where it doesn't fit in a hair bubble, and if you put it down it's too long. Like even for work it does my head in because I can't put it back. Oh, but yeah, I think I'm gonna grow my fringe out now. I don't know if I want to change the hair up already. Not sure. I feel like I will do though. Oh well. This is kind of cute, but I wanted to wear my hair down. I just don't know what to do. I mean, this isn't too bad actually. I've decided on an outfit. The hair is staying like this. I have this little bag here, crop top, okay, cardigan. And I'm gonna take the jumper as well and change into that when we go to Steelers.
I've now just parked up at Sheffield Arena, but we're making our way over to Centertainment to go get some food, and I think we're not gonna do bowling or golf anymore, just because of time. Either way, I'm excited to go eat because I'm hungry. We've just made it into Bella Italia now. I might get a hot drink, you know. My six spaghetti bolognese, like I always go for. One is carbonara. One is pizza. No, I think I'm gonna go for pasta. Looks nice. I haven't been here for quite a long time, so I'm really excited to try this.
Dinner has just arrived, my all-time favourite. And it's Simon's pizza over there, and we're about to dig in.
I've made our way out of dinner and we've come to the arcade. It's very loud in here, but we're just killing time.
86. Oh, I'm exhausted. A game of air hockey next. I'm gonna say I'm gonna win. We've just come in. Oh, it's very quiet. It's not very busy at the minute because we're about, well, an hour early to be honest. Might look at the merch stand, see what's there. The merch stand. T-shirts are about £20. £20 for a scarf. £40 for a jumper. How much is it for a jersey? £55. About £50 for a jersey. Some little bits down the side. £1 for a wristband. Not bad, little pens and stuff. That's really cool. That's my player because it's number 7, and number 7 is my lucky number. Coming into the stadium now. We're on our way to go find our seats. Wow, look. I'm so excited. We're quite high back. I think I explained earlier that I just didn't want to be too in the crowd for like the first game, but this is like, I think anywhere you sit, to be honest, is like perfect seats. They've sectioned it off though, like usually, obviously Sheffield Arena is much bigger, but they like half it, just so it's a little bit smaller. Just get inside. I think the last time that I was in Sheffield Arena was for Ariana, and that was in 2019, which was so long ago. But I think they've updated all the seats and they're so much more comfortable. Sheffield a little bit more now. We have 5 minutes till the end of warm-up.
How are you, Dan? Did you get up? Sheffield, Yorkshire, are you ready to rock? We're still the King.
left. And we're leaving.
Oh, it's cold. And somehow I've got to beat the traffic.
And I am back home. My first ice hockey game. They lost, sadly. They literally, Glasgow scored another goal just before it ended. 4-2 to Glasgow. Obviously, it gets very busy in the arena. So we was like, maybe we should go a little bit before. But I was kind of like, let's see. Let's stay and see what happens. But Glasgow scored again. Quite a few people just stood up and left and was like, yeah, us too. I just saw in the video there was like loads of different things happening. Just loads of interactive stuff, really. No, it was a fun atmosphere. But yeah, that was my first ever ice hockey game. That does it for today's video, guys. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to give it a huge thumbs up. Leave a comment down below and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Also, don't forget to press the bell notification to be notified every time I upload a new video. And I will see you all in the next one. Bye, guys.